Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you proper steps and things to pay attention to before prior start to welding, especially on the root. As I'm gonna show you the root and the steps with the prep on this 6-inch SCAD 40 pipe. So to begin with, the first thing first you gotta pay attention to is your torch, your nozzle, your gas lens, your shape of your tungsten, collet. This is most important thing before you even thinking about start welding. This is what you got to check for, any defects, impurities. It can be inside lots of things. As you can see here, the spatters, like from any paint on a pipe, galvanized, you're gonna have like little spatters inside. So the gas lens, it's gotta be clean. That's what distribute the gas evenly on your weld. Nozzle, same thing, that's what shields and protect your weld pool. And the collet, that's what keeps your tungsten steady inside and firmly. You don't want to have any wiggle parts. Everything got to be nice and tight. This is most important, nice and clean tungsten. The way how you sharpen, which angle, it all depends from you, from your personal preferences. Depends of the material, the tungsten, and what's the use for. They're all different. So I'm gonna show you here on this Miller Sinkerwave 300. This is all good beauty, really nice, good welding machine. The another most important thing is your gas flow for your torch. This is 30 standard cubic feet per hour, or in liters should be around 15 liters per hour setup. That's what I like to have for my setup. And prep pipe, most important thing. This is new pipe. Didn't clean too much from the outside. It's a good habit to clean at least inch from the edge. Tacks, root tacks, half inch up to inch long. Nice, good, solid root tacks. So you don't have to take them out. So you're just gonna connect to them. This is gonna be your tie-in point and start point, whatever you like. This is how they should. Root tack look like inside. You should have lots of meat, and I always like to start from the root, connects to another, start from the tack and connects. Then another thing, except the bevel prep, feather edge, someone like land, I prefer feather edge and a consistent gap. For nice, good, even uniform root, you need a consistent gap, especially when it's prefab like this, where you got lots of room and tool and time. This is around 5 mil all the way around, which is good. And so I like to do feather both sides of the tack. This is where we're gonna start and connect, or this is top start and our tie-ins, and always both sides feather them out, so you get nice proper smooth blend connection. The other thing too, pick size of your rod, 3/32 or 1/8. As I said, depends on your personal preferences, what do you like, what kind of gap. Someone like 3/32 tight, someone like a loose 1/8 like me in this case, or 5 mil. As you can see, a big difference with 3/32 fit inside that big gap. There's lots of room to wiggle. It's not going to be consistent. You have to go really slow with low amperage. To do that with the tacks both sides, I like to go 6-inch grinders, 6-inch grinding disc. You can do it with a 5-inch, it doesn't really matter. I got 6-inch, that's what I'm showing here. And then just do the both sides, don't touch the middle. Middle is where you're gonna stop and start. It's not a rule that you have to stop and start on a root tack. You can just go over and start somewhere, stop somewhere else and start as well. But just proper steps and habit, what I like to do, that's why I'm showing you. This is where you start, and this is when you start welding, as soon as you start melting that root tack. So the first thing first, once you initial your first arc, connect top and the bottom. In this case, it's a horizontal weld, so I got the foot pedal. As I said, the max is 200 amps my setup here, so the root is around 115 right now. Pay attention to the bottom as you can hold, the most important thing is just to hold that rod right in the middle, stretch that puddle. You can see the top is opening definitely, and then you want to be sure to burn the bottom edge as well. Couple things here, pick the size for your nozzle that's gonna fit inside the bevel. It's gonna be easier for you if you wanna walk the cup, if you wanna wiggle inside the bevel, so the nozzle is a good size enough, it's not gonna slip. There's no any obstacles inside the root, another thing, so you can have a really nice smooth path that you're gonna have a nice good control over your puddle and the way how you manipulate with that torch. It doesn't really matter if you walk the cup or you freehand, still same rule should be applied. All your weld area should be nice and clean. And this is the root. This is good enough meat, especially for the hot pass later. You can do one pass. Some guys do like two passes just in case they're afraid of the sack back. No need for that. If you got nice, lots of meat inside, you shouldn't be worried. As I said, I started on a half of that root tack. And as soon as the roots start getting liquid, this is where you add the rod. Try to have consistent move, so your travel speed, the way how you feed that rod, try to keep it always connected. It all depends, guys. I know you got lots of questions about the speed of your how you feed that rod. Well, you gotta figure that out by yourself. The way, as I said, your travel speed. So that means you have to feed that rod, keep it always connected to that puddle. And that being said, that's how you adjust yourself, both hands. So when you keeping that puddle liquid and you feeding that rod, that's your travel speed. That's your speed of feeding your filler wire. If you're too slow with your travel speed, and then you lose that connection, and then you're gonna create a gap, you're gonna start opening that gap, opening that edges, that's definitely the one you try to avoid. That's why your feeding speed and feeding technique plays a role here, and that's something you have to discover by yourself, by welding. And more you weld, more you're gonna learn. And as I said, you can keep it right in the middle, or you can keep it more to the top and then just stretch that puddle down. If you go too cold, you're gonna see it, it's too cold, too slow. There's even possibility that you don't even burn edges, especially on the bottom part. You're just gonna like a stick, just glue it, stick it over the edge, not burn it properly. And then especially if it's tight, you know, guys, like a lay wire technique on a tie gap is not really recommended. Especially guys, sometimes they go really hot and then they wonder if they got mistake, you know. I got tight gap and I was just running hot, but I didn't burn the edges. I got not enough pan. Why that happened? Well, that happened because you didn't see your what's going on, because you were just running over your wire and you didn't actually see, do you have proper edges and did you really burn them or not. That's why no need to rush, especially on the root. Root is most important part in welding. You want to have nice clean root. You want to see what's going on, as you can see here before on the edge of that puddle. You can see the edges are opening and I'm just holding with a little bit of inclination and I'm pushing with my tungsten, you pushing that material inside, so you got nice good proper penetration and your root should be nice and uniform. And always you can judge by the outside appearance how the root looks like. That's it for today's guys. I hope I help you a little bit with the setup, proper steps, what you should consider before and prior start to welding. And thank you for your support so far. Like and share and see you in the next one, guys. Take care.